Welcome, once again, Sacramento Popcorn Surprise, a very special episode, movies from memory.
This is a special one. Get in front of a fireplace, you know, light some incense, brew some tea.
You're going to hear about the good old days. This is where we review, or I shouldn't say we review, we recollect. We think about movies that we saw maybe once or twice.
Yeah.
Around the 80s or 90s.
Yeah.
But that's pretty much the extent.
Yeah, it's got to have been a while since we've seen it. But like in this case, I've seen this movie dozens of times. But it's been a while.
I'm not going to bury the lead. I'll get right to it. Miss Doubtfire.
Ooh. Is
it Miss or Mrs.?
Ooh. I was trying to remember that. I said Mrs.,
yeah.
But it seems like he would be Ms. because like it's a made-up character, so how could it be married? Her backstory... Yeah. I think she does mention something about like her husband in Ireland or whatever.
Okay, so I'm Dante. With me, as always, is Craig, and we have a very special guest, Artemio.
Very special.
We're
kind of wheezing the juice.
Wheezing the juice. Yeah, should we just talk about that? I mean, that's kind of like a...
Let's just talk about Pauly Shore instead.
Oh my God, I wish. So,
the characters.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Yeah, I guess we already explained it. Yeah. So
let's talk about a few of the actors that we have just to jumpstart.
Not the characters.
Yeah. Jumpstart our...
The legendary Robin Williams vehicle.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, right off the bat, this is best known for his, you know, his performance, I guess.
Yeah.
The titular character.
Yeah, exactly.
Sally...
So what's your vote, Art? Is it Ms. or Mrs.?
I would say Mrs.
Okay, I think it's Mrs. too.
I think we'll Ms. Robin Williams, Sally Field.
Yeah.
Sally Field.
We're supposed to...
What's that?
If you can remember everyone.
Oh, shit. Okay. We'll start right there.
You got Pierce Brosnan.
Yeah, Pierce.
Your bro, Pierce.
Harvey... What is it?
Firestarter.
Harvey Firestarter.
Yeah. I remember him. He's the brother.
One of the Lawrence brothers is in there.
Oh,
is that
shit,
one of the kids?
Yeah. Joey Lawrence? Oh, okay. Or...
No, it's like the middle kid.
Is it like
I used
Danny
to watch
Lawrence
that, like, that sitcom the three of them were in.
Yeah,
I was like,
that was hella good.
When I was younger. Right now, I'm still watching.
Yeah.
I think that's Joey as deep Lawrence? As I can remember. I remember that he has kids, obviously. But
that little girl from fucking...
Matilda?
Matilda, thank you. Yeah. That little, like, ridiculously adorable little creature.
That...
The
other sister was in Independence Day also.
She was
like
she's Randy Quaid's daughter.
Yeah.
For real.
Before he went off the fucking deep end.
In real life.
His character was fine.
he was method acting from Independence Day.
Oh my God. His life is now based off his character from Independence
Day. He couldn't escape the character.
Yeah, it's weird in the
it's
movies.
Like Heath Ledger.
In the movies, he fights for the government, but in real life, he fights against the government.
Yeah,
he fights
the
government.
Let's just start from the very beginning, I guess. I remember he, can you think of...
I don't think so.
When they're at that restaurant, isn't there somebody there that, like, gives him the Heimlich maneuver, or is that my man Pierce?
That's Pierce. Well, he's also going to see, well, we'll get there, but his potential boss, the, like, head of the of PBS or something, to give him a kid show.
Was that guy?
But I don't think he's, like, a very name actor.
Okay. I don't think I've seen... I don't think I can remember who that guy is.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm missing somebody, though.
Should I read off the remaining...
I think that's all of them.
The remaining guys you remember, or you can't remember, or wait till the end?
Yeah, I think just when, like...
Okay.
If you guys are down, just want to get there.
Yeah.
When we get to fact-check all of this. But we have pretty good memories. I take a lot of ginkgo biloba. To kind of help with my memories.
A lot of male vitality.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man. All right, who wants to start?
A lot of bull testosterone.
So this movie starts with Robin Williams in the recording booth.
I do remember that.
Is that what it is?
He's doing cartoons.
Yeah.
It's like, and he's
like
doing, like,
Spanish
improv,
voice.
And they're getting, like,
yeah, he's a little...
Yeah, can you imagine that?
It's a little risque, because he's adding...
Isn't he, like, doing kind of a Speedy Gonzales type... character?
I think so. It was something like a bird or a mouse
Getting
eaten by a cat.
Oh, yeah.
and then he's having this like weird discussion
with
it.
Wasn't it like Spanish or something?
Yeah, I remember that. And he got in trouble.
Yeah, and he's like, you said for improv-ing, right?
Yeah. He's a loose cannon, that Robert Williams.
I think they got pissed because, like, they'd been working late or something like that, right?
Oh, yeah.
And doesn't that lead into him getting in trouble for, like, not being where he should have been with his family?
Oh, yeah, okay. That's right. So he...
yep. Oh, you're talking about Daniel Hilliard. No, my bad. That's who Robin... That's Robin Williams' character name.
I thought Daniel Hilliard.
That's his character's character.
Oh, it's shit.
Euthygenia Doubtfire.
You're going meta right now.
That's right, man. There's a lot of layers to this movie.
It's a prequel to Being John Malkovich.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, so he... It starts out that obviously he... I shouldn't say obviously.
And it plays Jump Around at the beginning.
Plays Jump Around, just like we did. But he's the father of these three kids. He's having some problems with his wife.
Yeah.
I think like
His bitch wife, Sally Field.
Essentially a very nice person.
She's like super nice, yeah. She's just mad at Daniel.
Yeah.
Yeah, and yeah, he's having problems with her. Not really problems with the kids, like they adore him. But he's kind of being
He brings shame to the family.
Not disrespectful, but just like kind of irresponsible is the
word. Yeah.
Yeah, he brings shame to the family. Yeah.
To the Daniel crest.
And does he get fired at the beginning?
I believe so,
when he's like going off.
I think he pulls one of those, you can take this job and shove it.
Does he?
Yeah.
Like the great song? Dire Straits or some shit like that?
Oh, man. Dire Straits.
And then... I don't remember anything other than, like, from that point.
The jump around scene?
Yeah, to the jump around scene.
When it's, like, the daughter's, like, 15th birthday or 14th. Yeah. And I remember him standing on the table and rapping. Rapping.
Is that when they kind of...
sunglasses
just,
on.
They call it quits because she eventually, something happens and she's just like, all right, Daniel.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the kids.
She's, like, screaming, you gotta go. What are you doing? And he calls her a cunt, and then she... Where's that?
Go to the store, get a pack of cigarettes, and never come
back. He was doing lines with the kids without her. Without her.
Yeah. Even the Lord's brother.
Yeah. The Lord's.
And he had the music, like, blasting.
All the little sisters just looking out for narcs.
Oh, yeah. Pretty much.
Oh, my God. So, the only way that he can see his kids, because of Sally Fields...
She gets, like, full custody.
She gets full custody, and she won't let him see them at all? Or he wants more time, right?
Yeah, yeah.
He does get a little bit, right? He gets like one.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's like once
like part
a week
of a day a week.
Yeah, but it's not enough.
But it's not enough for Robin. He's a loving father for Daniel Hilliard.
Of course.
Yeah.
Sally
Field, famously known as playing the Flying Nun, as we all know and love.
This part, like the part, gets a little sketchy where he's like. Flooding her voicemail with like all of these terrible interviews and stuff like that.
He does?
Yeah, like
and he's screaming cunt in the phone.
Yeah, well, there's like
he probably shouldn't do that.
There's one where she answers and he goes, "Hi."
Upset the neighbors.
And, she goes, "Okay, are you applying for this?" And he goes, "I am job." And like that's the only line that he says to her throughout the whole interview.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's
man.
When he's applying places, right?
He's like. Because he finds out that she puts an ad in for a nanny.
You're right.
And
that's what it is.
And he starts flooding her voicemail like with all these different characters.
Back in the days
of
an answering machine.
When she finds that one, she'll be like, oh, like this,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
He uses his talents to like fuck with her. So then, yeah, she has all these horrible I am job.
He calls us Gilbert Godfrey. He calls us the I am job.
Yeah. And like one, you know, people with like priors. Arrests.
So his brother, I remember, is like in special effects and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So he
biased matchmaker.
Oh, Daniel, what's wrong?
And he's like,
did you get divorced?
I think I'm a woman. Oh, Daniel, finally! I've always known. Yeah.
And him and fucking him and Timon. Or no, is he Pumbaa? God, I can't remember.
Oh, Nathan Lane?
Nathan Lane. Oh, him and Nathan Lane are fucking hella hard in that movie.
Oh, it's those remember two. Remember that sex scene? That's right. I forgot that it was those two. I couldn't remember who the guy was
totally
with
forgot.
Him.
I totally forgot. Yeah, yeah, until just now.
That was Nathan a loud Lane. Sex scene. But his, yeah. his brother helps him out.
They're soaking at first.
They are soaking. It turns into a power wash very quick.
Very quickly.
Like, on the dime.
He's like, hey, guys, I need your help. And they're like, hold on a second, we're soaking.
This is my husband, Nathan Lane. This is my brother, Daniel.
Wasn't there a character in Rocco's Modern Life that sounded just like
the
that?
The big heads, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Is there really? I've been watching Hey Arnold with my nephews a lot. They're, like, all about it.
That's a good one. What about
I didn't
Recess,
really watch
man?
It as a kid.
Really?
Yeah, I didn't have, we just had, like, the network channels. I never had, like, the cable back then.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't watch, like, hardly any of the Nickelodeon shit.
Damn. That's, like, all I watched.
Yeah, it's a tough childhood.
So did you watch, like, all those, what Saturday morning cartoons did you watch? Did you watch,
I could watch, you know, there was, like, I don't remember all the ones that were Saturday morning, but, like, Bumping you know, Darkwing like Duck.
Oh, I love that one.
Captain
Real
Planet.
Monsters. Yeah. Oh, dude, that one was sick.
All Real Monsters, I think, was Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
But
oh,
it,
which one
are
you talking about?
Saturday morning cartoons. You're talking about, like,
okay, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Where it was, like, the Saturday.
I remember in the kind of later years, I was probably, like, 20. No, I'm just... But I was watching, like, Recess, Doug. Because remember, Doug jumped to Network.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
He lived in both worlds, yeah. And he goes to, like, 7th grade or something like that.
Really?
Yeah,
he
didn't
show up.
That's when I stopped watching. I didn't, like, I always watched, like, Fox cartoons.
Yeah, yeah. Because, like, yeah, X-Men.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I really liked... Oh, Bobby's World, yeah, Life of Louie. I dug X-Men, Spiderman, Batman the Animated Series.
Oh, yeah, that was all Fox.
Superman the Animated Series. Some of that was, like, 58 in Sacramento, which is, like... Now it's the CW.
Is that
like,
what
it was
Batman
WB 58.
Animated?
Yeah, and Superman.
On? Yeah,
yeah.
That was.
And
so
you know, you're right. Yeah. X-Men was Fox, and Spider-Man was
Fox.
I think Fox.
Yeah, because they would do
but CBS or ABC had a bunch.
You guys remember the X-Men Spider-Man crossovers?
No.
They oh yeah, they came episodes. On to Spider-Man. Dude, he had hella people on that show.
I remember some of the arcs they did with the Silver Spider and. He has like the arachnid legs in the
oh
back.
Where that mutation
yeah what is that what
he
is that
gets
called?
At some point I forget how it happens or if it's just like a late onset part of his like
oh
mutation.
Yeah I think that's what
it
was.
Takes like you know it's months later he starts to like grow
full oh yeah and he
limbs.
Becomes a man spider
he's man spider mm-hmm. And then in the one figure. I think you were talking about where he goes he talks to what was it, Madame Web or whatever
oh
he
yeah
he talks to her and she's like you gotta bring 5 other Spider-Mans from 5 different dimensions to team have like a Spidey team up and take on oh my god to me as a kid that was like this is the greatest thing I've ever seen in my life dude and one of the dimensions was Man Spider was still like he could still like he was intact enough to like, be a superhero. Right?
Oh,
if
okay.
That makes sense. Because
yeah.
In the regular one, he, like, loses control.
I thought what was nuts was the one that was, like, the evil twin. What was his name?
Was that where he had, like, the blonde hair?
Like the,
they
oh,
didn't
no,
go
no,
with
no,
just
no.
The
and
goatee.
The different suit.
The Star Trek goatee.
The slightly different suit. Is that Scarlet Spider?
Scarlet Spider, I think, is who Peter turns into when he thinks he's the clone. But there's, like, the clone, who I think is called Kane... Who like
really?
He gets like the Carnage symbiote and like
what?
Yeah,
they didn't do that. I don't think in the animated series
bro, they did.
Did they?
Yeah, that's when it started getting like nuts. That was when they had the like the Mary Jane arc where everybody thought she died and then she came back and you find out that she's just like a clone of that Hydra Man.
Oh, holy shit!
Like it was
yeah,
like around
yeah,
that
yeah.
era. Of
yeah, I remember that.
That shit.
Because one of the season finales was the Hydra Man. If I remember.
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
So then the next season was, like, what you're talking about, and it started getting crazy. Yeah, and I loved the Spider-Man with, like, a silver and black...
Oakland Raiders!
Silver and black
yeah,
suit that was, like, metal.
He was, like, the sellout.
It had, like, laser beams and stuff.
His
yeah.
suit was super dope.
It
was
so was,
like,
cool. But he was kind of a douche.
He just, like, marketed himself instead of, like, keeping a secret identity.
Yes. Yeah, it was like Iron Man, kind of. And then there was one, oh my god, might have been my favorite one, like blew my mind, where in this dimension, Spider-Man had defeated Dr. Octopus and integrated his technology, Like, because remember originally Doc Ock's suit, his arms, he could, like, put it around his chest.
Yeah.
And so, but then it, like, became part of his body or whatever.
Yeah, fused on. Yeah.
He got fused. But this version, Spider-Man defeated him and just, like, took the chest piece and made it part of his suit.
Oh,
so he had, like, four tentacle arm things. Oh, so cool.
I thought you were going to talk about the one who you find out that he had no powers at all. That Parker, wasn't he, like,
actor or something, or
he's like,
right?
I play Spider-Man.
Yeah, he plays Spider-Man and he doesn't have powers.
Yeah,
so he's like the cuck Spider-Man.
He's the cuck conservative Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah,
he didn't say it.
Peter Cucker. Okay, that was
all right.
We were talking about Tobey Maguire and Sam Raimi's Spider-Man.
No, hey, I think Willem Dafoe's here. Let's talk about it.
Hey, Peter.
Oh, my God.
Where's Harry?
So to Mrs. Doubtfire.
I love it.
A little bit of a detour.
I love it. If you didn't enjoy that, like, Saturday afternoon animated talk, then...
How do we even get to that?
I don't know.
Dude.
We told our age with that story,
We were talking about it, and I kept, the farther we got, the more I kept trying to think about what we were originally talking about.
Yeah.
Until
we were just talking about which of the Spider-Man was.
Yeah.
Dopest.
Well, we were talking about the Saturday, like, having Nickelodeon. Now, my horrible childhood, I wasn't given the gift of Nickelodeon. It's like
television, electricity.
Yeah, it's like people starving in Africa, little kids.
Mm.
I sort of know how they feel.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
I always felt it was weird.
You're such a humanitarian.
Thank you, yeah.
But it's weird there were kids that did watch Fox and kids that did watch, like, Nickelodeon. And then I always thought there were kids that, like, you either had Super Nintendo or you had Sega.
Yeah, they didn't cross over back then.
Yeah.
I was a Super NES all the way.
Did you guys hear Atari's making a new system?
The Jaguar? Oh, wait, that already came out. Are they really? I thought I heard that they pretty much went under, like, years ago, like in the late 90s or 2000, and so the guy sold, like, sold it to someone.
Oh, really?
So someone else, like, owns it now. And they just kind of put out, like, you know, remakes and stuff, I think, still. Of the old Atari games that they have the rights to. Dude Looks Like a Lady. This is the Beatles, right?
This is the Beatles.
Oh, no.
It's better. It's Aerosmith.
This is the Quarry, man.
And since they made this song for the movie, Robin Williams plays bass.
He does.
A lot of people didn't know that.
He does. He was the fluffer.
Especially didn't know this.
During the sesh, the live sesh.
He put, you know how Steven Tyler has like a little scarf on his mic stand?
Mm.
He used the one from the Miss Doubtfire set for this whole tour.
Oh,
okay, I'm making up a lot of facts.
So I think after he talked to his brother,
it's true.
Or his brother and his brother.
He got did up, so he was a lady.
Yeah.
Dude looks like a lady. And he has that Scottish persona, right?
Yeah, because remember, I think right before he sees
my brother Harvey.
There they are. That's not Nathan Lane. What the hell? We're thinking of the Birdcage, I think.
Yeah, you are thinking of Birdcage. And that's Robin Williams and Nathan.
Lane, that's what it is.
Oh, yeah. Okay,
but remember, before he goes to his brother's house, he's doing all the different voices and calling her in this amazing 90s montage. And then...
hello, I'd like to look after your children.
He does all these weird voices.
I am Job.
And then he calls her and is like... you're such a nice Doubtfire. No, I don't remember, but he starts it like knowing now I'm going to be the good job.
Yeah. It's why he plays bad cop with her over the phone.
And he does that. Yeah, now he's doing good, and then he does a Kaiser Soze moment and looks around the room. And sees fire on newspaper headlines. No doubt he started the fire or something like that.
Oh, we didn't start the fire.
Yeah, he just looks at his Billy Joel collection.
This is Doubtfire, dear.
And so he just
kept calling her Deary.
He's done the character. I don't know why he started. I'm just gonna do a Scottish woman's voice. Figure out what to do. After
how did he get the clothes?
Like, why not do like a New York man? Because
his brother was a costume.
Yeah. Then he goes.
His brother had it all.
To have the outfit, his look match the voice. His brother's got it all. He does that.
That's weird that his brother was like just down for his. for him to like dress up.
Yeah. And like, he's like, come on over.
Fake
your
identity.
You're not going to ask me anything about it. You're just going to start doing it for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Sounds chill.
Yeah. You want to dress up like an old lady, old Scottish lady.
I get it.
So that's how he had. Oh, because was that what it was? His boyfriend was like a costumes guy.
Yeah, that's what it was.
He was a facial makeup effects guy.
Yeah. I don't know. I thought.
I think that's what it was.
At the time, that was pretty good makeup. I mean, it looked.
It was. Yeah.
Like still now, he looks
just like an elegant Scottish.
Yeah, he looks amazing.
Senior citizen.
He looks very regal.
Yeah. And he gets like fake, like not just wearing a bra and putting like handkerchiefs in it. I mean, he gets like real nice fake like, prosthetic boobs.
Like, some gazungas.
Yeah, you might say.
And meanwhile, while this stuff's going on, Mama Bear meets this fucking...
Oh,
she gets that James Bond 007 dick.
For bringing that up, that's the first... Dick. I mean, that's when he makes his appearance.
Oh, I'm so sorry, it was a drive-by fruiting.
Sally Fields is looking to get stretched out. She goes out on the
bar. She goes to England and meets a special agent.
Yes.
007.
007. Mr. Bond.
What if the Mrs. Doubtfire universe exists within the realms?
Within the James Bond?
Yeah.
I think so. So she went on a date with Dr. No. Broke up with him.
Wasn't chill.
Met 007. That kind of worked out for a while.
Yeah,
he was dicking her down.
She,
Real nice.
I mean, real classy stuff.
Yeah.
Real nice.
Reverse cowgirl, all the hits.
All
the favorites.
All the hits, all the classics. Oh, yeah, Miss Doubtfire gets hired, so it's the kid's name.
Hilarity ensues.
She's a great
nanny. So much
nanny.
Knee slapping.
Yeah. And she ends up, like, doing a better job of nannying the kids and like living in the house, taking care of the house, than he ever did as Daniel.
Yeah.
Before he started cross-dressing.
As Daniel the piece of shit.
Yeah. Daniel the piece of shit.
He's just like huffing gasoline on the side.
And was doing cartoon voices.
He's running around San Francisco doing drugs.
Fights with his wife
indiscriminately.
And I'm pretty sure they moved into the Tanner house. The so-called Full House. No, but it looks like the Full House house, like in San Francisco.
I can't remember it that well.
It's beautiful. Oh, we got some theme music on.
Meanwhile, while all this is going on, the brother joins the super... What is it? The
punk band?
It's like Super Samurai Cyber Squad. You guys ever watch that TV show?
Was that a Lawrence brother?
Yeah.
Did a voice or something?
No, it was like it was kind of like Power Rangers, but it was about these kids and they kind of fought and like on the internet, not
oh
on the
my
internet.
God.
No,
like in
I can't
the
really
cyber
remember.
World.
That we should do. We should do a whole fucking thing on just that TV show.
On Beetleborgs. Oh, that's something else.
That was a.
It's a callback to the Saturday morning stuff.
Yeah, exactly. We're gonna do a podcast special podcast review show of the entire television series. Beetleborgs. So be sure to stay
You're
tuned
welcome.
To that.
That was Bandai, right?
That's right, bro.
They had that and like fucking VR Troopers.
Yeah. They designed toys and then they're like, shit, we should write a script for these toys.
And they show out of or that. Power Rangers was the first one though.
Where they designed the toys first?
Is that what they did?
Or just the same.
That was like the biggest.
I think Beetleborgs they did. Design the toys first. Like, I don't know if they came out first, but. It was more the show based on toys than the toys based on the show.
Oh, I gotcha.
Which I think Transformers was that way.
That was nuts. They did that with Beast Wars. When Beast Wars, it was like, Cheetor and the B one. I forget what his name was.
Bitch?
Yeah, the bitch one.
Honey?
It was like Wasp or something like that.
White
Anglo-Saxon
Protestant. All right. Well, I'm going nowhere with this.
We are sexual predators.
When that toy set came out, it came with like a VHS
I'm trying to remember
cartoon.
Who the...
Really?
Yeah.
There was Rat Trap, Cheetor, Rhinox.
Well,
I'm remembering these really well.
But Cheetor...
Dinobot?
Try to remember the Decepticons now, though. Because he was a Decepticon.
It was something very much to do with a fucking bee. Yeah, Beedrill. No, that's Pokemon. Waspinator.
Waspinator, that's what it was.
That's what it was, the Waspinator. Great character. And he always did
S's or Megatrons.
Megatrons on his way. Here we go.
That's like the same sound as Reboot when it starts.
Yeah, really.
It is, isn't it?
Listen to the metal guitar.
It's pretty metal.
Kids shows, their theme songs had like Steve Vai on like every kids show theme song. It's fucking metal guitar. You know, like the Spiderman one? That is literally metal. It's shred metal, like hair metal, shred metal.
I don't remember it, so let's listen to it.
Yeah. Spiderman, Spiderman. It had that like robotic voice vocoder.
Oh, I forgot about
that. It was Zap and Roger doing the fucking featuring Steve Vai.
They got together with Steve
Vai. Yeah.
To make the fucking
Spiderman, Spiderman, radio wacky Spiderman.
It's like Power
the
Man
dive
5000
bomb. Starts with a dive bomb. Oh, man.
This is the best.
It, like, makes me feel good, like, seeing the intro to the show.
Oh, what was the name of the dude that was in the wheelchair?
Oh, and then... Dude, I just was thinking about him the other day. Mr. Smythe.
Mr. Smythe.
BJ Novak played him in Amazing Spider-Man 2. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He's barely in it.
Holy shit, really?
Because me and Yoder were freaking out about it.
They said Mr. Smythe?
Yeah.
And then they, I also remember they said, dude, it blew my mind. It was on TV the other day, and I was watching a little bit. The chick who plays Jyn Erso in Rogue One, that, like, amazing British actress.
Yeah.
That boo, my boo thing.
Your boo?
She played Felicia Hardy.
What?
In Amazing Spider-Man 2. And she is like a secretary.
She played who? Oh, yeah.
A secretary for that Dane DeHaan guy who's Green Goblin, Harry Osborn.
Yeah.
And then he goes, I'm promoting Miss Hardy. Like, she's now, you all work for her now. To the guys in the board meeting. It's kind of stupid. But.
Dude, that movie sucked so
but
bad.
I was like... I think they were getting ready to set up her maybe being Black Cat.
That would have been dope. Yeah, cool. It seemed like they were setting themselves up, and then they just...
And it got cut out,
yeah.
I don't know. I liked both those movies.
I didn't like that they tried to force a Green Goblin in there like that.
There's definitely no reason to force... Not that, like, the Sam Raimi one was the most amazing one in the world, but it was like, we've done that now. Like,
yeah.
You really need the next one to be Green Goblin again.
Yeah.
Hey, Peter.
Well, and it was like...
Your Aunt May is a bitch.
Green Goblin, you need to take a chill pill.
Never. Where's Harry?
But I liked that in the Sam Raimi film. It's like, it takes a while for Harry to turn into the Green Goblin.
Yeah.
You see the transition.
They do.
And you can
it
care for
decently.
Why...
Yeah.
You care about why he's doing it.
Yeah.
But with Dane DeHaan, whatever his name is...
They just kind of like...
They, like, cram it within 30 minutes of a movie.
They kind
of
do, yeah.
And it's
because
like,
they're
oh,
like,
nuts.
Norman's already dead.
Yeah.
And, yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of problems with the second one. Like, I thought the most surprising, or you might say shocking part, my bad, was I thought Electro was done really well. Like, that was one of the better parts of the movie, I thought.
Well, I would have rather it just been a fight between Spider-Man and Electro.
Yeah.
Than ever even introduce...
No. They should not have done...
They should have introduced
I like
Harry Osborn
a lot, too.
I think they should have introduced him then and then had it culminate in the third film.
That's a good idea.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I still have to see Homecoming.
Oh, yeah. Homecoming is great, dude.
Oh,
Spider-Man,
yeah.
Homecoming.
Yeah, yeah. I thought you were going to say the second Amazing Spider-Man.
I like how
we've been...
talking about Spider-Man for this whole podcast, and we sprinkled a little talk about Miss Doubtfire.
There's a little bit of Doubtfire talk.
Yeah, that's
I love that.
Oh.
Okay, so we're talking montages, right?
Yeah.
So I do remember him slip
they
slide.
Do this one.
He's like running around the house cleaning
like
and
doing
shit.
A great job.
He burns his fake tits
thriving.
At one point.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Doesn't
what about the cream pie in the face?
Bronson comes over, there's a, you know, there's a miscommunication.
Bronson. I was like, what? Charles Bronson?
Where's the butter? Faster, faster.
Faster, faster, faster. Is this Death Wish, or is that Charles Bronson?
Brosnan, yeah. Or yeah, that's how you say it, right?
Yeah, Brosnan. I always hear Tim Heidecker say it like Bronsonen. Like he says it the worst way.
Bronsonen.
Yeah.
Exactly. I remember the drive by fruiting. They all go out to like the pool party or something. Yeah. And that's when he just says like, I'm not gonna go swimming or anything. I mean, how does he just get away with not doing the little things that you'd think?
That one, well, it's like, you know, he's so old, like he doesn't wanna fucking show off his body and
Miss Doubtfire's just a hot piece.
Just the old fucking lady. And they're asking her, if she wants to, and she's just like, oh, no, no, I'll be fine over here, having a drink.
I remember there's a Heimlich maneuver scene at one point, right?
I think that's at the dinner scene, the restaurant.
That's later.
Okay.
I think.
Well, okay, yeah, you're right.
I believe.
What ends up happening? So he...
Yeah, he's thriving as Miss Doubtfire.
Yeah.
Like, kicking ass. And then she's getting the daddy 00D dick.
Yes.
007 dick from Pierce Brosnan.
It's great. She's loving it.
She's loving it.
She's jumping up and down on the thing. It's crazy.
Oh, my God. He sounds so much like the real person. You think it was the real thing. I botched that. But, yeah. So he's... And then, yeah, what is there, like, a turning point? Is it the Heimlich
scene? I think the restaurant scene is the turning point.
Oh, his mask comes off.
Is that when he...
But see, is there two restaurant scenes? Because the whole movie, like, culminates with a really long restaurant scene.
This restaurant scene is important stuff.
It is, like, the whole movie.
It's like it wraps everything up. Yeah. It's like the culmination.
Because
have to do the, like... Being
that's what it
was.
Is that's
in,
what
in
it
the
is,
restaurant
think,
he has
yeah.
to switch between Daniel and Miss Doubtfire Euthygenia.
And he finally gets, and he's doing a good job of it. I do remember
because
it's
he's doing a good job of it.
He's doing a good job of it. I mean,
he is,
can't
first.
Complain. He has a date with his wife, and then he has isn't there like a date.
Or
for him in an actor or something?
No, he's at the party for Miranda Hilliard. God, I just remember that. Sally Field, Pierce Brosnan, the three kids, and they invited Miss Doubtfire to like a celebratory dinner. And as it were in Hollywood, it happens to be the same place in the same time. It sounds like a Three's Company episode.
But better.
But at the same time as, his meeting with that like other older gentleman that is like the head of like, something like PBS type of thing, he wants him to do. Remember there's a scene we forgot, he catches Robin Williams playing with, like, dinosaur action figures.
Oh,
You're the king of the dinosaur world, the T-Rex, and, like, doing all these voices.
He can't help
and he does, like, a rap.
Great character if he's alone.
Yeah, he just starts, like, acting when he's alone. And the guy, like, catches him and is... terrified by how much of a maniac he must be, but he thinks he'd be great to do voices in a kids show.
Oh, man.
Probably not be within 300 yards of an elementary school.
Probably not.
But do voices in a kids show would be fun.
So he's running back and forth between the two characters.
Yeah.
And then eventually, something happens and he's caught.
Well,
right?
Remember the first it builds because he almost gets caught when he comes back to the meeting with the president guy of the TV station, and the only thing I think he has left is he has a little bit of the lipstick.
Oh yeah,
and
then he have like a stocking on too.
Daniel, and he's like, you got lipstick on right now. Like, he doesn't know how to tell him, he's freaked out, and he's just like, oh, and he has that, like, you know, he starts like blushing, and then he's just like, oh yeah, one of the waitresses here, I used to date her. And, like, we got a little frisky in the bathroom.
He covered.
Doesn't his,
and the guy's
false teeth come out into somebody's glass at one point?
Yeah, that's right. The false Miss Doubtfire teeth. I don't remember which table that's at, but the person is, like, horrified. I think it's back at that guy again.
It's like Brendel Fly when he's falling apart. His teeth
exactly.
are falling out. Good flick, cool twist.
Yeah.
So the jig is finally up. He's
eventually
found out.
I think comes back in full regalia.
Yeah, yeah.
And the guy's just like, but he's talking like, oh man, the bathroom's so busy right now. And the guy's like, Daniel, You're dressed like an old woman right now. What the fuck's going on?
You're exciting me, Daniel. You're chubbing me up, Daniel.
You're hot. You're sexy.
You're chubbing me up.
The guy wants to fuck Miss Doubtfire.
Yeah, oh, that's the problem.
For sure.
When he finds out it's Daniel in drag, he kind of still wants to fuck
Miss Doubtfire. Even better. Two birds, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Mrs. Doubtfire is kind of like a smut film, though, when you think of it.
It's kind of like 8mm come to life.
Oh, my God. Come to life. Soundtrack by the great Howard Shore.
So, and after all that, after all that hilarity ensues,
just a long, awkward pause.
they all make up somehow, right? I mean, don't they stay divorced?
Yeah.
Damn, do they?
She gets a...
There's no happy ending?
She gets a restraining order, yeah, and he's put in prison.
She moves to another state?
Yeah. Luckily, they were in San Francisco, so they're, like, a little more open-minded about that sort of thing.
That's cool.
Now, yeah, they, he gets caught basically by one of the groups and then just like gives up, right? Oh, that's what it is. Someone, Pierce Brosnan, chokes on a shrimp. He was mad that he can't eat spicy things. I never understood that. Oh no, I can't eat that. It's spicy. Yeah, but the spicy didn't harm you. It was that you choked because you swallowed an entire shrimp. Mm. I never understood that.
That chewing thing?
Like they gave him spicy food and he wasn't supposed to, but that had nothing to
he
do with
the problem.
He just tried
to swallow it.
He just swallowed a whole shrimp and it got caught in his fucking stupid windpipe. And so Miss Doubtfire's like, hey, in his fucking Daniel voice.
He's fucking choking! This fucker's choking!
Doesn't he like jump over like tables
and
shit?
Yeah. Yeah, that's hilarious.
Steve Young's at one of the tables.
Oh my God.
That's great.
Because it's in San Francisco.
Yeah. So yeah.
It all comes together. Yeah.
Yeah, funny stuff.
And then they invited him out, and he threw a touchdown pass for the Niners in Miss Doubtfire costume.
So how does this end?
Miss Doubtfire was playing quarterback, but he was revealed to be Colin Kaepernick.
It ends with Mrs. Doubtfire marrying Robin Williams' character.
Yeah. This is one of those self-marriages.
That's the self-marriage. Call back to another podcast.
Wait, does he live as Miss Doubtfire, though, with that guy?
For the rest of his life, and he kills Daniel. They have a funeral for Daniel Hillary, and he lives as Euthygenia Doubtfire.
And he never talks to his kids ever again.
And he just sucks that...
Chubster?
PBS guy's dick every night and gets the job.
Sucks on that cut.
No! PBS guy!
The PBS guy sucks his dick. No, he... That's,
the guy from Reading
Ken Burns.
Rainbow?
Him and Ken Burns. And LeVar Burton. LeVar Burton. And the That's Amazing.
Ken Burns.
What's the That's Amazing guy?
You'll have
it. That's amazing.
That's amazing. This whole time I thought you were a woman, but you're really a man.
Wow. He gives up the ghost, so to speak. He gives up. So then he ends up like, yeah, I've been dressed as Miss Doubtfire the whole time.
Big deal.
She's like freaked out. And then somehow they make up, I don't remember, but he gets, like, more custody. Like, way more custody.
Because he's proven
and
himself.
She, like, stays with Pierce.
Really?
Don't the seven. Kids, the kids...
Two of the kids die.
Before.
No, I'm just joking.
They kill themselves after the change?
Yeah. No, you're right.
They do die.
They find out before his cover's blown.
Yeah, I think the sister and brother. The brother... him doing something like standing up and pissing or something.
That's right. That's
and remember, he looks the actor Joey Lawrence or whatever. He looks terrified. He's whoa, what's going on? Like he's scared.
Yeah, and doesn't he tell the sister or whatever? And he's like, she's a man or something like that.
Hey, come on, all right, it's me, your dad.
Oh man,
think about how much that would freak out.
Oh yeah.
And then you find out your dad.
Like, dad, you want to tell me something?
This lady you've been living with for, like, 2 weeks or whatever?
Yeah.
She comes by all the time?
It's your dad.
And then you're just like, oh, chill.
Your dad. You can stop wearing the dress and the brooch now, dad. I think it's okay.
I do it for your mother.
But the PBS guy, there seriously is a part where he's, like, attracted to Miss Doubtfire. I don't remember.
Ugh.
But when he finds out, too, obviously, in that same scene, like, that it's Daniel dressing up. He goes, you know what? I'm, like, freaked out. Like I said, you're a fucking maniac. I already knew that. I'm, like, almost more intrigued, though. Like, I still want to give you the job, but I think you should do it as Mrs. Doubtfire.
Doesn't Does he
and
do
so
it?
So he gets hired to do the job, the PBS kids show about informative kids show.
I feel better already.
As Mrs. Doubtfire.
I mean, everything's like coming together. It works out at the end.
He gets both.
Yeah, yeah, he didn't, you know, he didn't save his marriage, but he got his kids.
Oh.
And maybe that's all he needed.
Yeah. It's like you you're looking for something and you end up finding yourself.
It was always there. It's like so in front of you.
Yeah, pretty much.
And it looked just like Goldeneye.
Something was right in front of you all
along. Shall we take a look at what we got right, what we got wrong?
Yeah, we got right. Every second of it.
All
right. Hey,
favorite cream pie scene.
I always search.
That's
up
better
for
than
that
Brazzers
scene, cream pie, and I always find like all these other weird sites come up when I search for that. It's weird.
Like what?
Cum.
Oh,
mostly coming. Kind of scenes, to be frank.
Coming. Feels so good when the cum comes out.
And the theme music's amazing. Brings me back.
Do you guys want a long plot or something kind of like short and to the point?
Well, we need to find out the cast.
Yeah, the cast.
Who did we miss?
Directed by Chris Columbus.
Is it a Chris Columbus flick?
It truly is.
It is.
He founded the Americas, was horribly racist to Native Americans, and then directed Mrs. Doubtfire couple hundred years later.
Film came out in 1993.
Damn it. Oh, we forgot to guess the year.
After a bitter divorce, an actor disguises himself as a female housekeeper.
Voice actor.
To spend time. Did I say? Oh, yeah.
No, I don't think it says that, yeah. But he is.
To spend time with his children held in custody by his bitch wife.
It says bitch on there?
No.
Yeah.
I just had that. So it stars Robin Williams. Oh, here it is. Robin Williams as Daniel Hillard.
/ Mrs. the titular Mrs. Doubtfire.
Sally Field.
Emphasis on tit.
Oh,
Chiller.
Nice.
Sally Field is his wife, Miranda Hillard. Pierce Brosnan as Stu.
Oh, he's Stu.
Harvey Weinstein as Frank.
It's me, Frank. Daniel, why didn't you call sooner? Come over right now.
Polly Hollard as Gloria.
Polly Holiday?
Holiday.
Who the hell is that?
I don't know. The Gloria? Only one that I'm looking at, I remember. So this is the guy that Robert Prosky guy.
Matthew Lawrence. That's what it is.
That's the Lawrence bro.
Yeah, and the hunky Lawrence bro.
This guy, the Robert Prosky guy, Mr. Lundy.
Oh, that's the guy?
Yeah, he was the one that
was... PBS.
He was the PBS guy. Martin Mull there at the bottom.
Oh, Martin Mull was in it. Dude, I think that Gloria person, Polly Holiday or whatever, remember she was the, like, custody social services lady.
Oh, really?
I think so. I remember that old lady and... And she comes over to Daniel's house in that one scene, and that's one of the times he has to put the whipped cream.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Pop this. Yes, play that.
Harvey Firestein.
All right, well, I think that's, I think we've captured the essence.
Of the movie?
Of both.
Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah. This is how it opens. This is how it opens.
Emma stuff.
That's Robin Williams singing.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
A blast from the past.
This one we really remember, like, really well. Is he just gibberish?
I don't know. That part. I think he's just high on life.
Is this after Genie?
Yes.
I thought it was, but I'm thinking now if it's 93.
Oh,
it probably was, but probably really close. Like, maybe, what was Aladdin, 92?
Yeah, look it up.
Yeah, you gotta let, you gotta go out on that next one.
Yeah. Okay, right here? Or this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
What was it?
Oh, Aladdin?
What was it?
Papa's got a brand new bag. He dresses up like an old Scottish lady.
1992.
Oh, 92.
One year before.
Yeah. Because he was all about the voices, man.
Yeah. All right, well, we hope you like what you heard.
Give us some feedback. Tell us what the next Movies from Memory should be.
Yeah, give us a suggestion. It's been Sacramento Popcorn Surprise, movies from memory.
Ahoy, ahoy.
Thanks for inviting me, guys. I hope this never makes the airwaves.
Oh, I will, bro. Grab some popcorn.